the tale unfolds, we discover that Humphrey Chimpanier Wicker is a citizen of Dublin, a stuttering tavern keeper with a bull-like hump on the back of his neck. He emerges as a well-defined and sympathetic character, the sorely harrowed victim of a relentless fate, which is stronger than, yet identical with, himself. Joyce refers to him under various names, such as Here Comes Everybody and Havoc Childers Everywhere. Indications of his universality and his role as the great progenitor, the hero has wandered vastly, leaving families, that is, deposits of civilization, at every pause along the way from Troy in Asia Minor, he is frequently called the Turk. Up through the turbulent lands of the Goths, the Franks, the Norsemen, and overseas the Green Isles of Britain and the Ire, his chief Germanic manifestations are Woden and Thor, his chief Celtic, Manann and Maclure. Again, he is St. Patrick carrying the new faith. Again, Strongbow leading the Anglo-Norman conquest. Again, Cromwell conquering with a bloody hand. Most specifically, he is our Anglican tavern keeper, HCE, in the Dublin suburb of Chapelizod. So, like Ulysses, the ground zero here is the utterly mundane, middle class, tormented Irish people embedded in the detritus of the 20th century. But there's an effort to never lose the cosmic perspective, never lose the sense that we are, not individuals lost in time, but the front ends of gene streams that reach back to Africa, that we somehow have all these ancestors in conflict swarming and storming within it. It's a glorious, psychedelic, heartful Irish view of what it is to be embedded in the mystery of existence. Well, okay, enough arm waving. Now let's cut the cake here. River run past Eve and Adam, from swerve of shore to bend of bay, brings us by a commodious vicus of recirculation back to Howth Castle and environs. Sir Tristram, the Lord of Amors, for o'er the short sea, had passing core re-arrived from North Armorica, on this side the scraggy isthmus of Europe Minor, to welter fight his peninsulate war, nor had Top Sawyer's rocks by the stream Oconee exaggerated themselves to Lawrence County Gorgios, while they went doubling their mumber all the time. Nor a voice from a fire bellowed Misha, Misha to Tartok, Tsar Patrick. Not yet, though then a soon after had a kidscad butt-ended a bland old Isaac. Not yet, though all's fair in vanity, were saucy festers wrought with two and one Nathan Joe. Rot a peck of pause malt at gem or shen brewed by arc light, and Rory end to the Regan bow was to be seen ringsome on the aquafe. The fall. Ba 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 dal gara hagatak amina arong kwarak brontong nerung kwabang varahu tingat akuhur dimun wang amanun. Of a once Wall Street old par is retailed early in bed and later on life do it down through all Christian minstrelsy. The great fall of Off-Wall entailed at such short notice the fit shoot of Finnegan, Earth's solid man, that the Humpty Hill head of himself promptly sends an unquiring one well to the west in quest of his Humpty Tumtoes, and their upturn pike toe and place is at the knockout in the park where oranges have been laid to rust upon the green since Devlin first loved living. So, now, granted that the first pages are dense And it isn't all this dense, because even though the concept of fractals lay years in the future, the effort here is to tell the whole damn thing in the first word, to tell it again in the next two words, to tell it again in the next three words, and so on. So here in these first roughly three paragraphs, a huge amount of information is being passed along. First of all, we're given a location if we're smart enough to know it. River run past Eve and Adam, from swerve of shore to bend of bay, brings us by a commodious vicus of recirculation back to Howis Castle and environs.